हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम फॉर टुडेज वीडियो लेक्चर ऑफ गणित प्रावीण्य। इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न वन ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक इन द चैप्टर डिविजिबिलिटी। द टॉपिक इज टाइप्स ऑफ नंबर्स। वी हैव सीन मेनी नंबर्स लाइक 5 digit, 6 digit, 7 digit, 8 digit, 9 digit, राइट? सो देर आर सम टाइप्स ऑफ नंबर्स बेस्ड ऑन इट्स कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स। सो यू नो दैट, सी, इन आवर नंबर सिस्टम वी हैव 10 digits, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Okay, so all the numbers are made up of these 10 digits. If you observe, you will come to know that all the numbers are made up of these 10 digits, 0 to 9. Okay, so based on these, there are some types of numbers. So which are those types of numbers we are going to learn in today's lecture? Okay, so the first type of number which we are going to learn, that is even numbers. Even numbers. Okay, so what is even number means? Now see here, what is mean by even number? The numbers which are divisible by 2. The numbers which are divisible by 2, they are called even numbers. Now, divisible means what? When we will divide that particular number by 2, it leaves remainder 0. We get remainder 0. That means that number is divisible by 2. For example, see, in another way, if you want to say, then we can say that the numbers which comes in the table of 2, which come in table of 2, they are called even numbers, or these numbers are divisible by 2, so they are called even numbers. Fine. So if you see that numbers which are in table of 2, 2, then 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, 24, 26, 28, 30, 32 and so on. All these numbers comes in table of 2, correct? That means they are divisible by 2. If you divide these numbers by 2, it leaves remainder 0. You will get remainder 0. That means they are divisible. Fine. So these numbers are called even numbers. Now if you see the last digit of these numbers, if you observe this number, you will come to know that, see, the last digit of every number, either there is 208642, see, either there is 0 or 2 or 4 or 6 or 8, there is 0 or 2 or 4, 6 or 8. These 5 digits, if there is at the end of the number, then that number is called as a even number. So two definitions of even numbers we can say here: the numbers which are divisible by 2, they are called even number, or the numbers we are having 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8 at the ones place, units place, they are called as an even number. Okay, so let's first write the definition. The numbers, you also write down, the numbers which are divisible by 2, which are divisible by 2, they are called even numbers. Understood? Or the numbers having 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8 here write the digits. Yeah, okay. The numbers having the digits 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8 at the ones place. Ones place means at ones place means last, at the end. Okay, so they are called, they are called as even numbers. Understood? So these two definitions write in your notebook. For example, we can say, for example, let's write some examples of even numbers. 4,97,238. See, last digit is 8. That means if last digit is 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, that means it is even number. That means it is divisible by 2 also, okay? Then 9,37,42,504. See, last digit is 4, that means it is even number. So these are the even numbers, okay? If you understood what you have to do, write these and then write any 5 examples or any 5 numbers, any 5 even numbers of 7, 8 and 9 digits, okay? You have to write 5 examples of even numbers with 7, 8 and 9 digits. Understood? So this is the first type of numbers we have seen. Next type is odd numbers. Odd numbers are exactly opposite of even numbers. Even numbers are divisible by 2, odd numbers are not divisible by 2. If we divide the numbers, if we divide the odd numbers by 2, we get remainder 1. Understood? So they are called odd numbers. See here. See, the numbers which when divided by 2 get, it leaves remainder 1. That means they are not divisible by 2. They are not divisible by 2. So they are called odd numbers. Okay. The numbers which are not divisible by 2 are called odd numbers. If you see the odd numbers, first of all, we'll write the first definition. The numbers which are not divisible by 2 they are called odd numbers. Or if we divide that number by 2, we get remainder always 1. We do not get remainder 0. Okay, so we get remainder 1, that means they are not divisible by 2. So they are called odd numbers. Or in another way, now we have seen that the numbers having 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, these digits at the ones place, they are called even numbers. Now remain which digit? 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9. So if these digits are there at the ones place, if there is 1, 3, 5, 7 or 9, if these digits are there at the ones place of the number, then those numbers are called odd numbers. Or these digits are there at the ones place, that means those numbers will not be divisible by 2. So the numbers having the digits 1, 3, 5, 7 or 9. The numbers having the digits 1, 3, 5, 7 or 9 at the ones place, are called as odd numbers. Understood? So if these digits are there, 1, 3, 5, 7 or 9 at the ones, at the last of the number, then these those numbers will be called as odd numbers. Okay. For example, if you want to take C, thirty-two lakh sixty-five thousand nine hundred seven. Remaining digits write any whichever you want, but last digit should be 1, 3, 5, 7 or 9. 1, 3, 5, 7 or 9. Then that number will be odd number. Okay. Another example. Let's take 42,95,341. Okay. See, last digit is 1. That means it is odd numbers. Okay. So if you understood even numbers and odd numbers, they are exactly opposite. Even numbers are divisible by 2 and odd numbers are not divisible by 2. Even numbers ends with 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8 and odd numbers ends with 1, 3, 5, 7, 7 or 9. Okay. So these are even numbers and odd numbers. Pause this video, write this in your notebook, both the definitions, and write 5 examples of each kind. Okay. We'll move. We will learn now next numbers. Let's learn the next type of numbers, that is prime numbers, and next is composite numbers. So first we'll learn about prime numbers. What is mean by prime numbers? See, yesterday we have seen to find the factors of numbers, right? We found the factors of 24, that we got here. Factors of 24 as a 1 into 24, correct? Then we got 2 into 12. Then we got 3 into 8. Then we got 4 into 6, correct? So these are the, these 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 12, 24 are, these 8 numbers are the factors of 24, correct? So prime numbers means what, you know? Here 24 has how many factors? 8 factors, correct? We saw 30, it was also having more factors. Okay, prime numbers means what? Prime numbers means what? The numbers having only two factors. The numbers having only two factors. There are some numbers whose factors are only two. One and that number itself. One and that number itself. So such numbers are called prime numbers. For example, I'll tell you, see, the number is 13, suppose. The number is 13. So let's find the factors of 13. You know how we find factor of 13, factors of any number. First pair, always 1 into that number itself, because 1 is factor of all numbers and every number is factor of itself, correct? So 13 ones are 13, fine. Then tell me, is the 13 in any other table, or can you express 13 in another way except this? Is it in table of 2? No. Is it in table of 3? No. Is it in table of 4? No. Is it in any other table? Absolutely no. So 13 has only two factors, 1 and 13 itself, means that number itself. So this 13 is called Which kind of number? Prime number. Understood? Prime numbers. Prime numbers and composite numbers. These two numbers are related with the factors. Okay, so the factor of numbers are only two. If the factors of number are only two, one and that number itself, then that number is called as a prime number. So let's write definition first, then I'll explain you some numbers, prime numbers. The numbers having only two factors. Only two factors. That is, 1 and the number itself. 1 and the number itself. Are called prime numbers. Are called prime numbers. Okay, so they have only two factors, one and that number itself. Means these numbers, these prime numbers are not in any table except one and that number itself. Okay, they are not in any other table. For example, we'll start with the the first number. First prime number is 2. First prime number is 2. For example, we'll write here. First prime number is 2. Why? See, 2 has only two factors. 2 ones are 2. It is not in any other table except 1 and that 1 and 2. Okay. So 2 is also prime number. Then next prime number is 3. Correct? 3 is also in table of 1 and 3. Then next prime number is, can you tell me, is 4 prime number? No, because it is in table of 1. Except 1 and 4, it is in table of 2 also. So it has more than 2 factors. So it is not prime number. 5, if we talk about 5, is it prime number? Yes, it is in table, it is not any other table except 1 and 5 itself. Okay, then there is 7, correct? 6 is not there, it is in table of 2 or 3. 9 also it is not there, it is in table of 3. Except 1 and 9, it is in table of 3, so it is not prime number. Okay, so between 1 to 10, these 4 prime numbers are there, 2, 3, 5 and 7. Then there is between 11 to 20, there are 11, 13, 17 and 19. Between 10, 20 to 30, there is 23 and 29, correct? 23, 29, rest all are in some other tables. Then between 31 to 40, there is 31, then there is 37, okay. So these are called prime numbers. Between 1 to 100, there are 25 prime numbers. Between 1 to 100, there are 25 prime numbers. So what you have to do today, write all the prime numbers between 1 to 100. There are 25 prime numbers. So you have to find by yourself. Okay, you have to find by yourself. The prime numbers means you have to find that number should not be any other table except 1 and itself. Okay, so find such numbers. Write 1 to 100 numbers and find by yourself. Okay, so find those 25 prime numbers, 25 prime numbers between 1 to 100, which are between 1 to 100. Okay, let's go for the next, composite numbers. Composite number is exactly opposite of prime numbers. The numbers which having more than the numbers having more than two factors. Prime numbers means only two factors, one and that number itself. Then composite numbers means the numbers having more than two factors. More than two factors, they may be three, are called composite numbers. The numbers, that means what? The numbers which are not prime, they are composite. The numbers which are not prime, they are composite. Except one. Now see, the first prime number is 2, correct? And the first composite number is 4. First composite number is 4. Okay, then there is 6, then there is 8, then there is 9, 10, 12, 14, 15, 16, 18, 20 and so on. Then what about 1? What about 1? First prime number is 2 and first composite number is 4. Then there is no 1. What about 1? Very important. 1 is neither prime. 1 is neither prime nor composite. 1 is neither prime nor composite. Why? why one is neither prime means it is not prime and not composite also. It is not prime and not composite also. Why? Because see here, the numbers have prime numbers means what? It has only two factors, that one and two are one and that number itself, and composite numbers having more than two factors. Then if you will find the factors of 1 into 1, that means what? It has only one factor, that is 1 itself. 1 has only one factor, so it is not in comes it doesn't come in prime numbers also and composite numbers also. It doesn't satisfy the definition of prime number and composite numbers, so it is neither prime nor composite. It is neither prime nor composite. Keep it in mind. Understood? 1 is neither prime nor composite. So the first prime number is 2 and first composite number is 4. Clear? What you have to do today about prime number, write prime numbers, all the prime numbers between 1 to 100. There are 25 prime numbers, and rest are composite numbers except 1. So as there are 25 prime numbers and 1 is neither prime nor composite, composite numbers will be 74. Clear? So that was this was just for today. Today we have learned the types of numbers: even numbers, odd numbers, prime numbers and composite numbers. Write the definitions of all, and whatever work I have told, complete it today itself. Okay? If you have any doubt regarding this, you are free to ask. So thank you and have a nice day.